accept us, He's the most merciful, عز وجل. فالحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي شق أسماعنا لنسمع والذي حرك أعيننا لنرى. والحمد لله على نبض القلب. والحمد لله على جريان الدم في العروق. والحمد لله على النفس. والحمد لله على شربة الماء. بل الحمد لله على أن أعطانا القدرة على أن نخرج ما شرب. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ability to hear one another. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ability to see each other. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this heartbeat that we have no control of. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blood it runs through our veins and we have no control of. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the breath we take and the breath we take. You get one breath out, it's not guaranteed you're gonna get it back. You get it back, it's not guaranteed you get it out. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sip of water. And yet, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ability to get this water out of our body. جاء رجل إلى أحد الملوك فقال لو منعت عنك شربة الماء أتدفع نصف ما تملك؟ قال نعم إلا مت. فقال وإن انحبست أتدفع نصف ملكك الآخر لتخرجها؟ قال نعم. قال إذا احمد الله على ملك لا يساوي شربة الماء. A man came to one of the kings and he said, if you would be able to drink, would you pay half of this wealth you have just for a sip of water? He said, of course, otherwise I'll die. He said, if this water gets stuck in your body, would you pay the other half? He said, yes, otherwise I die. I have to get it out. He said, then thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a kingdom is not worth a sip of water. It's not worth a sip of water. فاللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطان والحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام وكفى بها نعمة. And this on top of everything that I just mentioned is the name of the Islam. ومما زادني فخرا وتيها وكدت بأخمصي أطأ الثريا دخولي تحت قولك يا عبادي وأن سيرت أحمد لي نبي. Enough honor for us to be a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To be a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you understand that you're slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are free from everything else. And to say, you become an honorable person because you understand what Allah created you for. And it's enough honor that we follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That he become the seal of the prophets and to follow his steps. And indeed, the only religion will be accepted on the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Islam. That's what Allah says. Inna al-deen 'inda Allah al-Islam. The religion will be accepted, it's Islam. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ. And the one who's going to seek other than the Islam as a religion is not going to be accepted for. And I don't mean Islam by peace. That's one of poor translation for Islam. Islam is submission. To submit. Fully submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fully to follow the order of the Quran and the Sunnah. When the Quran tells you this is haram and this is halal, you follow. This is submission. This is Islam. When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught you how to use the bathroom, then he completed the religion for us. So there's no space for us to come up with innovation. There is no space for us to come and say, let's worship Allah this way, because I'm going to get closer to Allah this way. The khalif al-bida. You walk into a very dangerous with the innovation for the deen. So إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. When the religion will be accepted and the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Islam. أحبتي من دفن البارحة كان أنه سوف يكون معنا اليوم في صلاة الجمعة. ومن معنا اليوم في صلاة الجمعة؟ الأمل يأخذه. Not just tomorrow or after tomorrow for صلاة الجمعة القادمة. The people we buried yesterday in the graveyard, it's not too far away from us here. They thought they're going to be with us here today in صلاة الجمعة. But they're not. And the people who's here today with us in the Salah, automatically they think they're going to be in the next Jum'ah coming in. البعض مات وهو يقرأ القرآن في غيبوبة على فراشه ويقوم ويخرج من غير غلطة، بل يقوم الرجل ويؤذن وهو في غيبوبة. هذه حقائق تستطيعون أن تشاهدوها على السوشيال ميديا. A man is in the deathbed. He's in coma. And he opened his eyes and he recited Quran with no mistakes. No mistake in tajweed, no mistakes in recitation. Neither in his memorization, mashallah. He's in coma. A man also in coma and the deathbed, he stands up in his bed and he makes adhan. And you can watch on the social media. I'm not talking about sahaba, I'm talking about people in our time right now. And an old man wake up from his coma and he makes fully wudu with no water in his bed. وَامْرَأَ مَاتَتْ وَهِيَ تَرْقُصُ. And a woman died dancing. And a man died, they come and tell him, say La ilaha illallah. He say, give me a cigarette. Give me a cigarette. Or maybe he recite one of the songs that he listened to. The La ilaha illallah that we all say every day. Everybody thinks it's an easy, a Muslim, I'm going to say it all the time. Proven fact, people can't even move their tongue with it. They tell him, say La ilaha illallah, and he wants to hear his song. And he wants to hear his song. And a man dying in ihram, and a man dying in a session. جرت العادة على أن من عاش على شيء مات عليه ومن مات على شيء بعث عليه. This is the reality. The one who's going to live on something, he will die on it. And the one who died on something, he'll meet Allah with it. What are we preparing for that meeting? This is the final destination. It's a fact. We're going to die. It's a fact, we're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, a naive person that will think, keep running away from this meeting. Because you never heard that somebody died and then he came back after death. Never. Never. And you never seen somebody going into the grave and for whatever reason he has today, to tell you, I am busy that to live my life according to the deen and be closer to Allah, whether it's my kids, whether my wife, whether my business, whatever it is, the list goes on. We never see it and you're never going to see it. When they put him in the grave, then one of his kids wants to go with him in the grave. And one of his wife. Never seen that, right? This is the reality. This is the reality. That you must prepare for that day. You must prepare for that day. Allah says, وَلَقَدْ جِئْتُمُونَا فُرَادَ كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وَتَرَكْتُمْ مَا سَوَّيْتُمْ وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِكُمْ. Clear. You will come alone in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you came alone. And Allah says in the completion of the ayah, وَتَرَكْتُمْ, you left everything that it was taking away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the reality. مَنْ عَاشَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ وَمَنْ مَاتَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ بُعِثَ عَلَيْهِ. وَنَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ حُسْنَ خَاتِمَةٍ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the good ending. The good ending. If you want a good ending, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. First ayah will be, you know, الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. Allah said, you hear this in all the khutbah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Allah is directing the conversation to the believer. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, taqu Allah, fear Allah, fear Allah. Yaqul ibn Mas'ud, an yuta'a Allah fala yu'sa wa an yuzkar fala yunsa. This is taqwa. This is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you don't disobey. You obey Allah and you don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you remember Allah all the time. Where is our hearts after Ramadan? Who have been reading the Quran after Ramadan? It's not too far, a couple of months away. Just gone. How many pages did you enjoy to put your heart and your eyes in it after Ramadan? No more Taraweeh. Have you not at least couple of rak'ah before you go to sleep? You were here, standing for 8-20 rak'ahs every day, mashallah. What happened after Ramadan? So, an yuta'a Allah wa la yu'sa, wa an yuzkar fala yunsa. You remember Allah in your health and in your sickness. You remember Allah in your wealth and when you're poor. You remember Allah when you're strong and when you're weak. You remember Allah in the occasion that Allah sent to us. Allah is Rahim, Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Kareem. Every opportunity He gives in our way. And some of us just decide to turn it back and leave. Ramadan comes 30 days, full school of opportunity for us to get this heart attached to Allah. So that what's after Ramadan? The question is, ماذا بعد رمضان? What's after Ramadan? What happened? All our iman went like this in Ramadan, mashallah. We manage. We manage the time. Everything was in control according to our religion. We come to the masajid, we read the Quran, mashallah, great. What happened after Ramadan? The dunya takes us back. Dunya. Dunya. That Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is just la. Wala. It's just a game. Allah described this dunya like this. Allah says, is this dunya worth a win of a mosquito? You can't even see it with your eyes. Allah says, if this dunya worth a win of a mosquito, He would have made the kafir drink for him. The disbeliever drink for him. If it's worth it. But it's not.
Look what I have done. You excited.
So if we live our life according to the deen of Allah, and our ham, our concern is the deen, that we, everybody is good at something for that deen. Some, mashallah, very good reciter. Some, mashallah, they can teach the kids. Some maybe they are a businessman, and when they do business, they will reflect on Islam and they show the people what's good about Islam. Some sister by just wearing the hijab outside will show the treatment of Islam. This is Islam. Everybody, kullu yusr lima khuliqa lahu. Everybody has his own ability, his good ability. If you live with this mindset, you're gonna say, I need to meet Allah. I can't wait to meet Allah Azza wa Jalla. Show him what I have done for this deen. That should be the mentality, because time is very, life, time is gone. We all feel it and we all see it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying the question to that, فَمَنْ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَةٌ فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. Take this ayah and understand of it for this week. That's your homework. Just take this ayah, what I just mentioned, and understand Surah Taha. Allah gave exactly the script. This is the Quran. This is the miracle that we live with. We all believe this is the word of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah says, "Man ittaba' fa man ittaba' hudaya," the one who's gonna follow my guidance, my Quran, my Sunnah, the way the Sahaba understand this deen, and you live a very nice life. Allah is telling you, you're not going to have misery in this life. You're not going to be uncomfortable. You're going to be very happy. That's what Allah says. No misery and no misguiding. And the one who turned his back, the one he got excited in the khutbah for 20 minutes or 15 minutes, got very excited, the iman went high, as soon as they leave, they forget about everything. Right? وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً. Listen to the word. Danka. One of the heaviest words in the Quran. Danka. Your life is miserable. Miserable. No matter how much money you have. No matter how much education you get. No matter what you have. You're miserable. That's what Allah says. There is something that's not satisfied in your heart. You're missing something. Because you didn't do it according to what Allah wants. This is in the dunya. What's worse in the hereafter? You'll be standing in the day of judgment and Allah explain how tough is this day will be, you're gonna be blind. That's what Allah says in the Quran. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. أَعْمَى, blind. You can't imagine with all the horror of the day of judgment that we hear in the Quran. The description, all the description of that day. With everybody saying, nafsi, nafsi, me, me. Everybody will be selling their mother, their father, their kids. That's the how tough this day is. This day worth 50,000 years. And for the believer, that's between Dhuhr and Asr. And between Maghrib and Isha. Isn't it worth it then to look? Isn't it worth it to live with this body here and your eyes? It's in the hereafter. Jannah, arduha as-samawat wal-ard. A heaven worth the size of the earth and the sky. This is what Allah gave it to us. Listen to the description of Allah in the Jannah. Not just enough that Allah says, "Nashur yawm al-qiyamati a'ma." Now the conversation with Allah. Rabbi lima hashartani a'ma. Wa kunt kuntu basira. Oh Allah, why am I blind right now? Because I used to see in the dunya. Yeah, maybe you have an eye, but your heart was dead. Maybe you have basar, but you don't have basir. So why Allah, you bring me blind for that day? قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَةٌ فَنَسِيتَ وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. Nothing worse than that. Our ayats, our reminders, our good things comes in your way, and you turn your back. So we forget about you today, and this is the worst thing that you can have, that Allah forget about you. As if he doesn't even exist. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that to guide us inshaAllah to the deen. We ask Allah to benefit from what we heard. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to understand our deen the right way. This is the aqidah, this is the foundation, that's what you need to understand. Quran and Sunnah and Tawheed, and the way that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us this deen with the way of practice of his sahaba. When you have this strong foundation, you can build on it. You can build on it. than to understand who you run to, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the destination. What's the end destination? Is Allah. فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Everything you get scared of, you run away from, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Run to Allah. When you're scared of anybody, you run away from him. But with Allah, you run to him. You run to him, Azza wa Jalla. So, اعلم أنت. Know who you worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Qawi, Al-Aziz, Al-Rahim. When you know who you worship, now you're going to see what is the rule. وعليك الصحبة. صحبة الخير. And make sure you have the good company. Make sure you have the good company. When you ask anybody, he's in jail. Why you are in jail today? Because of the people that I was hanging out with. And in this deen, whatever is going to grab your deen to get you closer to Allah, يُحِبَّكْ فِي اللَّهِ. He loves you for the sake of Allah. You want to strengthen that. You want to strengthen your community with that love for the deen of Allah. When we meet each other in the masajid, it's only for Allah. When somebody do something in the masajid, it's for the sake of Allah. Let's build our community, let's build our family base. And la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. Allahumma hdina fi man hadayta, wa afina fi man afayta, wa tawallana fi man tawallayta, wa afu wasrif anna sharra ma qadayta, innaka subhanaka taqdi bil haqq wa la yuqda alayk. Allahumma ya wasil muqatta'ina sunna ilayk. Allahumma ya wasil muqatta'ina sunna ilayk. Allahumma hdina wa hdi bina, waj'alna sabran liman ihtada. Allahumma asturna fawq al-ard wa tahta al-ard wa yawm al-ard. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal-muslimin wa adhill al-shirk wal-mushrikin. اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الارض ومغاربها يا ذا